Sagittarius, hello beautiful soul, how are you? My name is Alicia, welcome. This is Empath Tarot, where spirit's messages directly correlate with being highly sensitive here on planet Earth. Now this is going to be a general reading, so if it does resonate, like, share, and subscribe so we can get spirit's message out there to fellow empaths. If you are interested in scheduling a personal reading with Spirit and I, all of the details will be down in the description box below. And for even more empath energy, check out my husband. You will love him. He gives such practical, easy to understand messages and guidance from Spirit, particularly in the niche of business. His information is going to be down below. But without further ado, let us dive right in. Sagittarius, and it is Sagittarius season officially, so happy birthday to all you Sagittarians who were born on this day. It is a beautiful time to be alive when Sagittarius season is about. Let us see what we have going on. Now, it's feeling like there is an endeavor that you're trying to figure out and calculate and, you know, get this energy kind of lined up so that things feel flowy and things feel easy. The universe is recommending that you, instead of efforting this, and right now I feel like there's a lot of pieces of the puzzle you're trying to piece together, right? All the experience you've gained, the information you've piled in, your intuition. I feel like there's so many places we can gather our understandings from. And in order for these understandings to kind of piece together and fill in the puzzle, there needs to be a moment of silence, if you will. There needs to be an energy of stopping the thought processes, because when we are reaching for this and then reaching for that, we're like, oh, this together and this goes together. We tend to almost confuse and overwhelm ourselves in a sense. And the universe is recommending that at this time, all of the information that you have acquired, your experience, knowledge, and intuitive downloads, and your guides and angels, of course, it all comes together with a all of a sudden like an aha awareness when we take the time to stop thinking about it. Because whenever we are energetically connected to something, it means that we are in a trying sort of energy. And it's good to almost like, that's why it's like you almost want to like flow through life just absorbing from here and here and just kind of piling it in your sort of, you know, your library of information. However, you don't really want to necessarily connect to it. It's almost like if you were like studying a new diet, say you want to change your diet and you're studying all this information. You'd be creating beliefs around this diet so strongly because of the belief systems of every other being that you've heard that has been successful on this diet. However, this diet may not even end up working for you, but because you've been studying all this information, the belief system around it now is that it's supposed to work. It's supposed to work. So I don't know why it's not working for me, right? And that's the problem with ingesting so much information and not just sitting in silence with our guides and angels and with the universe to piece it together and feel out, is this the right way forward? When we're so busy trying to make it work, we don't have time to stop and smell the roses and think, is it even working? Maybe this isn't even my path, right? And a lot of the times that will happen. So the universe is letting you know that right now, in order for you to get to where you need to go, it's important to take some rest for yourself and meditate on this so that you don't disregard what your intuition is telling you the most. And again, your intuition will be able to communicate with you exactly where you need to go when we stop trying to force this. Stop trying to force change. Stop trying to create a new energy for ourselves. It doesn't need to be forced. It needs to be guided. It needs to feel effortless. And again, it only feels effortless when we stop to feel out what this feels like. It's important to keep our energies focused on an outcome of our desire, but not so much in such a way where we also then remind ourselves that we don't have it, only so that we can feel what it feels like when we do have it. Because as we know, this is a vibrational world and one that we attract our desires to us when we are vibrationally vibing at that same, in that same frequency. You see, so at the, like attracts like. So if you want $1 million in your bank account, what you do is you feel what $1 million in your bank account would feel like, right? Freedom, enjoyment, joy, a celebration, right? You feel that, oh, it's in there. It's going to be so great. I got all this stuff planned. Woohoo. And you just feel that good vibe around it and you leave it there. You might drop it at that. And that goes the same with any career that you're looking to build, any relationship you're looking to enhance. You just feel what it feels like when it's at its peak, when it's at its best, when you wanted it to be exactly where you want it to be. That's what you feel. You leave it at that. You channel that energy in and you etch that into your energetic feeling so that every time you think about what you want, that's where you go to. That's the energy you feel. Not what you don't have, not where it's currently sitting, and not where the journey you have to go to get there, because that is just going to be completely debilitating and it's not going to get you to where you want to go. What's going to get you to where you want to go is if you take your power back in this scenario and you start creating your life from the creator perspective that you came here to do. And that is not to worry and wallows or try to force a change because you're so unhappy with your circumstances. To the same energy that a problem is created, it cannot be solved. We have to change our energy to solve the problem. And what that really means is we have to change our energy into more of a high vibrant, this is what we're expecting, right? Expect the best because you deserve it. And at the end of the day, the problem is that whenever a manifestation comes forward of what we want, we always at the same time, when something we truly want, we also almost remind ourselves that we don't have it or how far it's going to take to get it or how long the journey seems. And then so we don't even start. And so it's like we want something, but at the same time, we're like, what's the point? You know, it's too far of a gap that we're reminding ourselves. So Sagittarius, universe wants you to know that everything that you're putting energy towards is going to be created with that Three of Wands, and it's already on its way. It's already on its way for you, baby. You got nothing to worry about except for where you place your focus. Because the law of attraction tells us, right, we cannot just stop thinking about something. It just doesn't work like that. It's like, oh, you're heartbroken. Stop thinking about them. Oh, okay, well, who said no one ever? That's impossible. But what you do is you rechannel your focus and your energy into something of greater value so that you can pivot your energy from one thing to the next and get really good at that. That's an energy alchemist, right? We can move energy around, move our where our energy goes. It's like it's the secret sauce to surviving here, thriving here in this human experience, because truly where our energy goes is where our awareness goes is where energy flows. And so when we can get used to dialing it into a channel that and a frequency and energy that supports us, that's when things get really, really good here. And it's interesting to know that you are in the pristine time to create this new beginning for you. So whatever it is that you are looking to establish, whether it be a relationship or whether it be a project or career of some kind, the universe is letting you know that you have all the tools, you have all the necessary information, you have everything, the experience that's going to be required to get this thing to where it needs to go. You got this. The only thing that will hold you back is your thoughts around it. And so that's why the universe is saying, make sure you take that time to disconnect from those resistancy thoughts, because that's the only thing that's standing in your way right now, Sag. That's the only thing that's standing in your way. Get your take your power back, and so you can take the lead back. Because at the end of the day, this is your movie. This is your life. Anytime you think about you want to do something, and then your mind takes you to maybe somebody's opinion or what it might do for someone else, and it might interfere with their life, that is a limiting beliefs. That's what the mind will do. You'll think of something from an inspiration, and then the mind will try to coax you into every single reason why it's not good, why you shouldn't do it. And at the end of the day, we have to fight that. We have to, again, become the energy alchemist of our lives and channel our energy into the abundant aspect of what's going to happen. Yes, of course, there's always going to be a what could be, but at the end of the day, you know that anything that the inspiration leads you towards is your guides and angels directing you in the path of abundance. We know this internally. It is engraved in us. It is our natural instinct to remember this. It's just the more that we practice the vibration of ego and of limiting beliefs and of scarcity, that's where our minds will immediately go, and it will feel more familiar. So we'll almost give into it. But the more that we can start to carve our own paths and look for that inspiration and that path of least resistance and do something we're not used to doing and be that leader, even when those around us don't match our energy and we're out here by ourselves knowing we got to take on this next journey, even though no one else is supporting us, no one else is believing in us, that's okay, because your guides and angels believe in you and they're the ones that are channeling that inspirational energy through you. And when you take the plunge and you listen to yourself and you take the lead of your own life, that is when everything changes for you, because you start to recognize, that voice, that feeling, that's what's guiding me. That's what feels good. That's what got me here. Then you're going to have that for the rest of your life. It's like the first time you realized, you know, you could, you went for a run and you're like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. I can't even believe how good this feels. I can't even believe I wasn't doing this my whole life. And it was right here for me and it didn't even cost me anything. And it was absolutely amazing and so full of joy. And it was right here this whole time. It's the same energy when we do something that we don't think is going to be good for us. We have all these limiting beliefs, this resistance around it, and we just rip the band-aid and we do it because everyone's saying that we're supposed to, but it just doesn't feel right. And we do it anyway. It's unbelievable. It's when you realize for the first time that you know how to fly. And when you discover you know how to fly, you never want to walk on land again. You always want to be flying, baby. And that's what the universe is encouraging for you right now, Sagittarius. It's your time to fly. So do not doubt yourself. Trust where the universe is guiding you through your inspiration and go for it. All right, Sagittarius, I hope you enjoyed your reading. I hope there was a message in here for you. If there was, like, share and subscribe. I truly appreciate you. Spirit loves you. I love you, Sag. And until our next reading, keep shining, baby.